he told me he was going to do it about a year and a half ago when we were talking about publishing Cry Father. He said he was going to launch a new imprint. I actually didn't know he was going to pick Pike as the first book, but when he did, I was obviously very honored. And more honored to be in that lineup with guys like Jake Hinkson and Peter Ferris and Todd Robinson coming out, Krista Faust. These are some of my heroes, so it's wonderful to be in the same group of guys and gals. Oh, I'm influenced by all those. Cormac McCarthy, Harry Cruz, Larry Brown, James Crumley, Ed Abbey, pretty much everybody that Gallmeister publishes. You know, and there's a few others. I mean, I'm a huge fan of Flannery O'Connor, for instance. I read her every year, continually. There's just so many people. I steal from everybody I can. It's two men. It's the story, essentially, of two men. I wanted to write a modern-day outlaw novel, something like Pat Garrett and Billy the Kid, you know. I realized about halfway through I was writing a bad Sam Peckinpah script, but that's okay. I love Sam Peckinpah, good or bad. It's about a guy who's a tree trimmer. He works clearing power lines in dangerous parts of the United States during the winter. During the summer, he stays on this mesa in southern Colorado, based on a place I dearly love and will move, and meets another guy, the son of a friend of his, who's a drug runner. And my hero, he's lost his son recently, a couple years back. He's very heartbroken and trying to heal from that. And so between him and this other guy, they manage to do everything but heal. I have two children, a boy and a girl. I'm a single father, so I spend most of my time obsessing over my relationship with them and how bad I'm messing them up, you know, screwing them up. So in a way, I always say that Pike was my book about screwing up my daughter, and Cry Father is my book about screwing up my son. So all my fears about parenting go into those.